Hello, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Minuscule Craft. I'm here at my base. Gonna do some work around here today, but I figured I would start off with showing a couple of things that I've been doing in between episodes. The first is this little lever right here. You just jump up here and we'll go ahead and break this block. And you can see it's one of them fancy little torch tower dealies to go downwards. A downward vertical torch tower, I guess, is the easiest way. It takes a long time to run, but if you look down here, right now we can see all the beacons. If I flip this, it takes a second. Now they're covered, and they'll turn off here in a second. Yeah, there we go. And that's mostly because I can't think of a better place to put them. They're in a really convenient place. I picked that spot to be convenient for using it, but not so convenient for necessarily not being in the way of the Valley of Doom sign. Stop being loud, fucking pigman. Fuck off. Making all this noise over here. So I added a shutoff valve to the old beacons for the sole purpose of being able to unblock the sign. And if I go in here, let's see, been in there. That's not new, This is new. I've been working on a map room. So this is the map of just my base area, which used to be just out in front of my bedroom. So they got moved into here. This is the map of the industrial park, which I just copied out of the war room. So you can see it's actually got the marker on it in the war room. And then this is a map of everywhere. So every wall, it's not filled out obviously yet, but I was gonna make it smaller. I had planned on making it just like a 3x5, but my base is here. There is like the temporary bases. This is the industrial park. This is Red Shirt and Wino. That's where the old Western town, the racetrack and crap is. And way up here, way up there, that's Corey's base. Him being way up there is the reason that the map has to be this big and is a square instead of rectangular. So, yeah, this is a long project that's going to take a while, but I'll eventually have a map of the world at large. Seen that. This is just a little micro farm that I've built before, so in case I need to make some carrots and stuff, which I did. I added a back door to get out the back here, which I'm gonna do shit with eventually. And I think the only other new thing would be down one more level, which is just a little cactus farm. Not that I have any great need of cactus, I was just bored and I wanted to build something that I didn't necessarily want to build on camera, so I built a cactus farm. Because it doesn't need to be built on camera, because everyone is seeing me build a cactus farm already. And if you haven't, there's a previous episode where I built the big one in the industrial park, so you can just watch me build one there, which is a lot better than this one, so that's what I've been up to in my base in between episodes, doing a little bit of adding some stuff. And yeah, so today we're going to be working on something interesting. It's time to start upping the security of the industrial park of my base. So right now anyone can just walk in this portal and they can go walk up here unimpeded and just storm my throne and take my castle. Like, you don't want anyone doing that. So what I'm going to build is a contraption up inside of there. And actually, let me make a little cut here. I'm going to jump onto a single player world where I've actually built this contraption to give you an idea of what we're going to be doing. So let me jump over there. One sec. Okay. Ignore what's going on up there. That's something else that I'm working on. I haven't quite worked out how to make it work yet. I'm effectively dubbing this the murder hole. I'm sure this is not a revolutionary design. I'm sure other people have built it before, but if I flip this lever, it opens up and it starts firing a crap load of arrows out on a very fast clock. Now normally these arrows would be various tipped arrows. I'm going to put poison tipped, And the painful ones and the slowing ones, all three, because it'll randomly choose what to come out of there. But let me just turn this here off. You can see it fired out quite a lot of arrows there in that short amount of time. Let me empty out my inventory. Let's see just about how many it fired. So like 2.5 stacks in that, what, 30 seconds it was running. So it's basically just a, so let me turn this on. It's got a piston and a block that both get pushed down by these two pistons. This block is, oh shit, gonna be powered by this redstone. So once it gets pushed down into place, it just gets pushed out. And then there's just a very fast clock off an inverter off the same line that goes up here and fires the dispenser. So, and I've been able to even cram in like a whole bunch of storage for arrows. So you could jack up a pretty good security system with this. You could even probably do a little compacting on it. I just built it, I didn't do a whole lot of tweaking on it, because I figure I'll just tweak it as I go, as I'm building it on the server. So let me jump back over there and we'll start getting things ready to go. So I think the ideal location to put this is going to be like right over here on top of the portal, shooting this way. So basically I would be up here in my base area and I would see it and I could trigger it. I think either I'm going to build this out a little bit and add like a little area up on here where you can go in and trigger it from. Or I might, like, there's this secret doorway here that I might push back a little bit, because it just goes into this little altar area, which is, it's still pretty cool. I want to keep this, but I might cut this hallway down and put like the hidden entrance like right about here, and then I could effectively like create a little area here which would have all my defensive controls, because this is just the first of many defensive systems that I'm going to add. The first of many. I'm gonna sleep. My base should be pretty spawn proof, but I'm still paranoid about creepers, especially when I'm just out in that area. So, but for now, I'm just going to put the trigger controls for it effectively right above it. So where the old potion brewing section was, up in here. Oh, I thought maybe I could grab the ladder as I'm flying, so I'll put like the controls for it up on here somewhere for now, until I figure out what I'm going to do with that area. Like, the base is starting to come together. Like, obviously still need to do all the huge walls and crap, and there's a lot more to do on the inside. There's probably some more little areas I need to add on the outside here, but things are starting to come together with the overall look for the base. So I think for now I'm just going to go over here and start digging out an area to put this device in. So where's the portal? The portal is here. I think this block, this should be the magic block. This will be what opens up when it fires out the arrows, because that should put them like in this general area, I would imagine. Based on the arrow trajectory, like take out this area, so just inside the portal. I think that'd be good. We'll have to see exactly where it gets to once we got it built up, but let me get this area dug out and we'll start looking at building the thing together. I'm gonna put some temporary blocks down so I can get out here and we'll start digging in. So, all right, I'll be back in a little bit. Okay, I think this should be a big enough area for us to build in. We'll find out if we need to dig out any more. So the first thing we need to do, so that's closed, that's retracted, sticky piston, and then temporary block. We need to go ahead and put ourselves a sticky piston right on there, which is going to be used to grab that block. And then, alright, so that's going to be down, up, the pistons, and then, okay, good. So I need to put sticky piston facing downwards here, and one over here. Go ahead and take that block out. And I think that should be good for that. So now we need to put block there, block here and here, and then we can start bringing this down. Yes. No, we need to go one more out because it needs to be our repeater as well. And then we can start bringing it down. Over, this can come down. Come on here, just a little bit of maneuvering around here. And all right, I think that should be what we want, right? I guess we don't even need that block anymore. This design, because we're not going to put anything down here. So where's my redstone dust? So let's see. Go here, along here, up here, here. Let's put that dot, let's go ahead and put a repeater down on two ticks, and that should be this system working, so let's test it out here. So that's retracted, and it pulls in, we get ourselves a nice little opening out, and we're not blocked in the back, good. And it closes correctly. It opens correctly. Alright, perfect. So this part is done. Take this off. Why am I hearing a zombie? Did he not die on the fall? I can't see down there. I can't see down there. I don't know why. Alright, well, whatever. I hope he died when he fell on that, but whatever. Okay. So, how am I going to power this? We need to bring an input from up there. So if I take out, say, this block, what is that block? That's just that block. So then I put a block over it and put a lever on it and then do what with it? Maybe monostables down, or not monostables, observers down. That's not really going to help me much. Oh, but I can just put a block here. But that's not really going to help. Maybe if I put the lever right on the floor, I guess. That's probably going to be my best option. So put that there. Stick a lever right on it. I can put one here. Oh, come on. And then, what? Take one here, and then there, right into it? Is that gonna be just that easy? Oh. And I should do is go flip my beacons back on so I get jump boost. Oh, come on. Why can't I make this so easy? Why can't I just get up here? Go up and then off. Oh, fuck. Alright, I'm just gonna pillar up a little bit. Is that. Alright, let me get this wired up. I'll be right back. Holy crap. Okay, this should be all wired up now. Yes, most excellent. Okay, so let's go ahead and open it up for a second. Get back down here. And I need to put the dispenser against that. Dispenser. Boop. And then I want to shrink, or I want to close it because I don't want the dispenser circuit active. Back down here. Come on now. Okay. So, I need to put a torch right on here. We should be able to. Oh god. Power up the line. I need to go there, 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 and there. This is going to be a comparator. This is going to need to run back around into itself as well. Right, right, this should be right. So if I put a bit of redstone on here, take a comparator, nope, that's a repeater. Don't think I have comparators in my inventories. Put a comparator down here. Put it in subtract. And loop her around like that. That should get us our clock, right? Oh, come on. Get back up here. Flip the lever. And we should see. Yeah, our super fast clock running. So if I put there and then here. Oh god, no. I need to. Okay, let me shut this down. I need to move that line around. Let me move this line around. I'll be right back. After some finagling here at the redstoney bits, I think I've got this working. I'm just going to toss in all my arrows for now. Let's get up here and flip this switch. Oh yeah, there they go. And they're peppering exactly where I thought they would. That's pretty great. I don't want to walk out in front of it too much, though. Oh, that's exactly what I wanted to have happen. It already burned through my whole stack of arrows. Perfect. So let me get some more arrows. See if I can locate my dragon's breath. I took a quick look earlier and I didn't find it. I may need to fight the Ender Dragon again before I can make any tipped arrows. But I do want to load it up with a whole bunch of arrows at the very least. So let me get set up for that, and then we'll put this into a real test. Okay, I cannot locate any dragon's breath. But I do have 3 shulker boxes full of arrows that I'm going to put in here. As you can see, I'm not wearing any gear. That might be on purpose. Might be allowing myself to get killed by my own murder machine here to test it out. I'm going to have more than I need to fill this up, so that's quite alright. Let's fill this bad boy up all the way. Let's go ahead and fill this hopper up and then stuff whatever I can in here, and I'll just stuff the rest back in here and I'll deal with them later. For now, I'm going to go and climb up here, flip the lever on. Oh, look at it go. Now I'm going to kill myself for science. Here we go, for science. Oh god. Oh, actually took longer than I thought it was going to. Let me get out there and shut that system down so it's not firing all those arrows. Run. But I believe we have a very successful murder hole of murder, arrow doom. I just need to get myself some dragon's breath so I can build up proper. Look at all the arrows down there. Just look at them all. This is like 2 stacks of them. Oh, and there's a couple down here. Oh, and there's some more down here. It's like 3 stacks of them. Oh, that's a lot of arrows. So yeah, I think we built ourselves a successful death trap. Look, there's still some in the wall too up there. Can I get down there and get them? Oh yeah. Ow, I hurt myself though. So I do believe that this is a successful machine. I'm pretty pleased with what it does. I do need to fight the Ender Dragon again now though, because I need to get a whole bunch of dragon's breath. So that might be upcoming soon. Maybe I'll fight it by myself. Maybe we'll see if we get the other no-skillers to come along. I'm going to definitely have to test out this murder trap on them a little bit, though. So, yeah. If you enjoyed this episode, go ahead and smash that like button. If you aren't subscribed to my channel, subscribe so you can see all the cool shit we got coming up. And all that. And yeah. Other than that, I am out of here.